Hi, today's lecture is about the vision designed for the aging. This is a diagram of the eyeball. Starting from the window, the cornea is a window that lets the light to the eye. In the middle of the iris, called pupil, that controls how much the light to the eye. Behind the iris is the lens, which can focus light along of camera. Right inside the eye is the retina, which sends the light impulse which carry on the optic nerve to the brain. Acuity is a sharpness with which a person perceives a visual image. It is a measure of resolving power of the vision. Acuity is a measure with a Snelling chart and is expressed in terms of two numbers, like 20-10. 20-20 level is what a standard person, that is a normal acuity, can read from 20 feet away. But the healthy young eyes often exceed this standard level. For example, a person with 20-15 vision indicates that what a normal person can see at 15 feet, that a person can see from 20 feet away. So it means that he has a level of better than the normal acuity. If a person has a score of 20-200, that person can only see at 20 feet from what most people see at 200. It's quite a bad vision. A person whose best optically collected acuity is worse than 20-200 is considered legally blind in the United States. This picture shows a mean visual acuity y-axis as a function of its x-axis. The plot combined the result of many different studies show that with the increasing age, there is a steady decline in the visual acuity for most people. This is an interface of Microsoft 2. The top panel shows an icon palette. The bottom panel shows how the icon appears similar with the bird, simulating the lower visual acuity.
Shimon!
Contrast sensitivity is a measure by testing the lowest level of contrast, light and dark, that an observer can distinguish. An observer may be show letter of varying density and ask to list as far down as possible. There are two types of the visual search. The first one is about effortful search. So this one user require an attention and operate slowly. And the second one they call the P-attentive search. So you can see from the red cereal box that you can find it very easily on the shelf because it's red. How can we describe P-attentive processing? So it initial processing information by our brain where certain characteristics are immediately detected without focusing on the object. For example, you can see the red dot in the blue dot or the all red. And you can see what is different from the other. What did you see in this picture? So this picture is a dashboard. For example, you can see the red color of the number, like 99.54% is outstanding from the list. And if you're looking on the graph below, you can see the line of the red line. That is distinguished from the other line. There are three main display technologies in use today. The first one called cathode ray tube or CRT. The second one called liquid crystal display or LCD and e-paper technology. So all of this display will interact to the aid-related change in visual ability that may be make reading more difficulty. Contrast ratio is a ratio or comparison of the brightness, white, and the darkness, black, part of a display. The CRT has a problem in terms of the glare due to the brightness, and the LCD has a problem in terms of the contrast ratio that makes more difficult to see for the older adults, while the e-paper has a problem in terms of the ambient light that's surrounding in the room. Pixel density. The unit of the pixel density is the DPI. The higher pixel density will more pixels per unit. Anti-aliasing. Small burly text may impact older adults and more than other age group. The PNT alias depend on the specific computer configuration and setting. 8. Relating high-level visual perception deficit. Aging have more trouble recognizing meaning or unlabeled symbol, such as an icon, actually the small one, and they have slow on visual tasks and decrease ability to tell if similar objects same or different. More difficult reading moving text, more likely to lose text of skin pointer. This example of the visual perception deficit, and it decrease the visual comparison that is similar together. For example, you can see the skin lock is quite similar to the upload file when it's small. As a result, you can add the label under the icon. Vision chain, the aging have a problem. For example, the ability to focus close, high glare sensitivity, and low contrast sensitivity. Vision disorder, sometimes they have the problem in lens yellowing and the problem in retina. So they cannot see clearly in some spot of the lens. Various font property, the sensory font have been shown to be slightly preferred over slip font by the older because the visual cluster is reduced. Which one is easy to read between A and B? And why? Which one is easy to read between A, B, and C? For the design guideline, you can use the sensory font that's size 14 and make use of back font on the white background and avoid using the fancy text. The scrolling is a problem for the older adult because they cannot click accurately, so you can use a link instead of scrolling at the end of the web page. When you're designing a web page, you should avoid the pattern of the background because it creates more cluster and make it simplify less information. The contrast should be sufficient enough. It shouldn't be white font on the gray background. Visual search. When user meet the unfamiliar menu, it will be a linear search. It will search from top to down, left to right. For the familiar menu, it will be non-linear search. The visual search in older adults have significant change in eye tracking speed and accuracy, reduced ability to detect change in visual stimuli, decline in peripheral vision. This is an example of the eye tracking tool. The lady looking on the some spot that had highlight. You can see left and right eye. With these two, you can measuring the guess time duration. In summary, we're talking about the human factor for older adults, such as a visual acuity, contrast sensitivity, pretentive processing, pixel density, visual perception deficit. And we're talking about the design guideline, such as a font type, size, visual search, scrolling bar. At the end of this chapter, we would like to ask you, how can you design an interface that is easy to use for older adults?